Welcome everybody back to the Spinner Rack. I'm here with my boy
Kelvin Ellis with Rock
CE, and today we're going to be talking about a review of J.J. Abrams' new Spider-Man. Cal, what's your take on this? Can a TV producer, extraordinaire director,
obviously
actually do his own comic book?
Obviously, we see it right here. Number one, and number two, it's hot as hell. I'm not sure why. I'm not sure. I read it. It's not bad, it's not awful. I don't find anything, astounding about it. It's a solid story.
Mm-hmm.
I think it does tread some ground that's been done already, but it's entertaining. I'm just trying to understand why this book is, as hot as it is, other than it's J.J. Abrams and his son are both working on this?
I'm not exactly sure if it's
something. Yeah, J.J. Abrams, his son is what, Henry Abrams? I think it's a father and son team. I definitely could be wrong.
I'm not 100% sure, but I got to say two things. The art is really good. I really like the art. The amount of money they put into this is good. The story is decent. I can't knock it. I definitely like the fact that this story basically takes place in, I guess, it's an alternate Spider-Verse. And in this Spider-Verse, Spider-Man, of course, married Mary Jane, and they had a kid together.
Benji.
And she ends up dying. Or something happens to her. Sorry, was that a spoiler?
Yes.
Damn. Cut it. Cut. So in this comic, he marries Mary Jane, and something happens, and they have a child. And, well, you know about that stuff. If I have to tell you that.
Please. You know me? There was so much spec on this book because of the introduction of this character, Benji. And they were like, wait a minute. This character was already introduced in another Spider-Girl book. But
yeah,
this is Spider-Girl, but this Spider-Girl took place in an alternate timeline, a timeline that hadn't been realized. So they were like, okay, well, Benji, this is his first appearance. I was like, you've got to be kidding me. You're going to get a spec book based on another, of an alternate timeline, based on another alternate timeline, and these two things haven't even merged up or anything of that nature?
That is completely nuts.
Well, a lot of guys went into this thinking that this was going to be something that was going to happen, that somehow this was going to be like the new, I'm not certain how they promoted it, but guys went back and spent, that book, it was a Spider-Girl 59, that book was going for $80 at one point. And I was like, based on what? That's a what if, this is like a what if, and you're going to buy a what if about this what if here? I was like, I can't do it. And then, of course, when everybody's like, hey, I don't believe this. There's no money in it. I was like, that wasn't the brightest move. Maybe it'll work out for people, but I looked at it and said, okay.
So this is officially the first appearance of Benji. Or is that other book still there?
I can't tell you. I can't tell you. I don't know. There has been an appearance of a Benji Parker in Spider-Girl, but that's set in an alternative timeline. This is also set in an alternative timeline. It's two totally different timelines, but it's like, so you're buying that book saying, what's the first appearance of, it's like, that Benji, this could be a totally different Benji at the end. It's just wild.
Yeah, well, hey, the key thing is that it's a good book.
Yes.
It's a good story. It starts off. Those with classic Spider-Man may have some problems with this, with the way they portray Peter Parker, but, it's evolution. And I was really surprised because there's only been two major, I guess, TV guys that we know about who's come off and done some comics that have been somewhat successful. And so we have, number one, the guy who did Angel and...
Joss Whedon.
And, of course, he went on to do Avengers and stuff like that, so he's done a fantastic job there. And then we also have the guy who did Babylon 5.
J. Michael Straczynski.
He had an interesting run there. There's another guy, the guy who's the head of the whole CW. We saw him over at, I think it was Long Island Con. We saw him at a table.
Greg Berlanti?
I think it was Berlanti, yeah.
I don't remember Berlanti doing any comics.
Yeah, he's there. He's doing something. He was writing some comic.
I mean, J. Michael Straczynski he did Rising Stars, which was with Image, mm-hmm. and that was very popular. That was very popular at the time. So he had already had some success there. And, he had a very good approach. And then when he came over to Marvel, his track record, his track record followed him. So he did definitely did a good job. Then he came over to DC and worked on Superman, and not so much.
Yeah, well, pretty talented guy. Hey, I want a reimagining of B5, guys. Come back with Babylon 5 if you can. They're doing everything else. Can't knock B5.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Of course, this wasn't a segue. But overall, we got to give this a thumbs up. We think it's a good first impression. Continue the story. Hopefully it's a limited issue because there's so many doggone Spider-Man titles. I can't keep track of them. Can you?
Well, this is a limited.
Okay, good. Just want to make
sure. It's not an ongoing. But that's why they said it in an alternative universe.
Yeah, because then you can do a whole bunch of stuff. There are other stories that you're like, what the hell? But hey. Sorry?
The only thing I'll say, this is not a Peter Parker story. Okay, this is going to be a Benji Parker story.
Yeah, this will definitely be a Benji Parker story. And it's pretty interesting in itself. So, Spinnerack,
out.
Thanks.